So, welcome to True for Champion number 5, the last episode of the week. Last episode with my Players Cup 2 Finals team. Next week I will swap to a Buzzwole team I already built. I only have to get it in game. And yeah, I'm really hyped to use Buzzwole next week. I think it can be really good as an anti-Urshifu counter. Let's see. We dropped a fair bit of places, but I don't mind that. And we finally don't face Zapdos Rillaboom stuff, but this is also really scary because I don't have good switches to Spectrum. Only switch is Grimmsnarl, and Grimmsnarl is really bad versus Feeny Whimsicott. I do scare Whimsicott Spectria. I feel like that's really good lead versus my team. Not quite sure how I can handle that because I also do not know whether or not this Spectria has Will-O-Wisp. Because if it does not have Will-O-Wisp, Landorus is really good. Maybe Landorus is really good regardless. Like Landorus, Grimmsnarl could work. I think Katana, Feeny maybe? Maybe a little bit weak to Rillaboom. But Rotom really isn't too good, and Feeny gives me an endgame versus like versus Motra stuff. And if I bring Feeny Rotom, I'm a bit weak to opposing Feeny. I don't like this matchup too much, to be honest. Really don't like it too much. This makes me think that it is indeed a support Spectre. So what I would like to do is like Scary Face Max Quake that slot. Or even Scary Face Max Airstream to outspeed Moltres next turn. It doesn't really have a switch into a Max Airstream, right? I mean, Max Quake would be better to get more special defense, but I feel like I want to outspeed Moltres next turn, but he could. I mean, does it matter if he brings in Whimsicott next turn? Then he's faster anyway. Yeah, I think that's the reason why I want to go for Max Quake. Max Airstream is better if he switches in, like Rillaboom. Okay, no switch at all. Spectre doesn't Dynamax. So as long as it doesn't protect, I should get the KO. And now Max Quake, I think, would have been better to stay a little bit more tanky versus the Moltres. But I fear the potential Rillaboom switching, predicting my Max Quake. That's why I went for Max Airstream. I mean, Max Airstream is good if he does not have Whimsicott in the back, but I assume Whimsicott's in the back. If not, Max Airstream was a decent play. Max is Moltres immediately, that's fine with me. No protect, okay, please don't be random Sash. Okay, great. That's really good. I assume Max Airstream? Yeah. Into Grimmsnarl? Okay, we take this. I mean, next turn I get my light screen off and Max Quake, whatever comes in. unless it's Whimsicott. This Whimsicott. But with Fiend in the back, I should be quite fine with this opposing Moltres. The only thing I fear a bit is Tyrant this turn. I think I'm fine. I think I will go for the Max Airstream. I mean, I just don't know whether or not Max Rockfall with Sandship will KO. I don't think it will. That's why I go for the Max Airstream play and Light Screen. Yeah, there's the Tailwind. Nothing I can do about it. But Moltres shouldn't get the KO here, right? Yeah, I feared Max Darkness into Landorus a bit, and then next turn he could go for Max Darkness again and fake Tears, but luckily he didn't do that. And next turn he cannot get a KO on both. He can either KO Landorus, I think he could. No, he could. I think even with fake Tears he couldn't. So he's pretty much forced to attack Grimmsnarl, I think. So what I would like to do is, let's see, I don't think I want to Max Rockfall the Moltres. Am I? I really don't want to trigger weakness policy. So what I want to do is maybe Max Quake this slot, cover for a switch, and set up a reflect in case there's Rillaboom in the back. Yeah, I take this really well. Let's see, maybe he didn't target Grimmsnarl, but I would be shocked if he didn't. Oh, Gleam, okay. Then the Reflect was my only play anyway. I mean, I can't Scary Face Moltres, I cannot do anything about it. I thought about switching Grimmsnarl out into Fini, but since he went for Max Darkness, my special defense would have been at neutral anyway. And the only thing I would have taken was a Dazzling Gleam, and I don't think that's worth. I think I will search on Fini here. Because of its Rillaboom, I will get the terrain. It's Terrakion, okay. I think I'm fine with that. Good thing is that Landorus is the fastest thing on the field as soon as Tyrant is over. And he lacks damage output towards Fini right now, I think. How many turns of Tyrant? One or two? Two. I think what I want to do is, like, Earthquake this turn and protect. And next turn protect with Landorus to stall out the last turn of Tailwind. He will just spam Fiery Wrath Rock Slide. Seems like it, right? I also thought about switching Landorus out to get Intimidate, but I don't think that's needed. Let's see, maybe I don't flinch. Please don't flinch. Okay, I don't flinch, that's really good. Because now it's a 3 versus 1 and Fini should be Moltres And I also can, like, protect the. Oh no, I had to go down. Never mind. I was like, okay, I can protect Stored Entertainment and then Landris is faster. But obviously I can't because I run life off. But unless he has, like, Quick Attack, which I doubt he has with Life Orb, I think I was fine, because the next turn I could have went for Protect with Landorus, Swallowing out the table and stuff like that. But now I will just Smart Strike and I will Calm Mind. No reason not to. Just play around the Policy and the Berserker, and then I should be fine. I think we recover all of the damage with leftovers. Okay, I think he's in range of a double up, right? The only thing I fear a bit is him flinching one of my mons and then I put him into range of anything. So what I might do is, I think Leaf Blade will hit him into range anyways, right? Yeah, shot. Might as well just double up, right? Okay, because if he doesn't get the flinch, I win. Okay, he cancels. I was like, I mean, even with the flinch, I think Feeny would get the KO, right? Even if he gets Policy and Berserker, if he wants to KO Feeny, he has to go for Hurricane, and then, like, Katana gets a free attack, right? But I think unless he gets, like, ridiculous amount of flinches with Fire Breath, I should be fine anyways. But I think forfeiting wasn't the play. I think there was a small chance for him to win this game. Okay, Spectre stuff again. Why am I facing always Spectre Grimsicott? That's really annoying. I mean, Katana looks good here, besides the Rotom and potential, like, Helping Hand, Max Phantasm stuff. The fish is also really scary. I definitely need Tapu Fini. I'm just not sure whether or not I want to lead it. I mean, Grifter looks fine here besides the two fairies. But setting up the screens could be valuable. I'm not really sure what I want to do here. Lando is just so bad because of Choice Scarf. Maybe Katana Grimmsnarl with Feeny. And what's the last? I mean, all of my last ones are weak to fish anyways, right? I might as well go Rotom to have a better Glastrier answer. That. I can at least protect with Rotom. I mean, Landorus can protect as well. But Rotom is at least very good versus Glastrier. Man, this hyper offensive Spectre Whimsicott stuff really picks up in usage. They always lead this. I don't know why. But I know that my Katana is in a really good spot. And I know that I will set up a light screen. Because if he wants to KO Grimmsnarl, I think he has to double up. And then I get a Smart Strike off. And besides Rotom, he has no switch in. I mean, I could also target Whimsicott, but maybe that's a better play. I'm not sure, I will deny the Tailwind, but I think he's faster than my whole team anyways, right? It's just Tapu Lili switching out is a bit more obvious. But I want to cover him staying in. I mean, lot of Tapulilis just stayed in versus my katana for some reason. And once again, they stay in. I don't know why, but they seem to like to stay in and take this mass strike. I think he has to Moonblast if he wants to KO. Oh yeah, I'm faster because he's not Scarf. So that was really great for me. I don't really get that play at all. But I take it. I take it all day. Now also terrain is gone, which is really valuable for me. There is the Spectre. Just I don't have a switch, and that's the bad part. Let me think, what can I do here? Could switch out into Feeny and like Spirit Break that slot. Trying to stall out the max if possible. Spectre is really annoying if you don't have a Ghost immunity. I'm not quite sure how much damage he will do. I mean, I have Light Spin up, but it's Spectre, most likely with Life Orb, having hand potential. The thing is, I'm pretty sure that would have KO'd my Katana even with Dynamax. And I don't want that to happen. Okay, I think that I would have taken that, and Finny takes this really well. That's really good. Now I also get my Spirit Break off, which is very valuable. And late game Katana looks really good now. I assume Rotom is in the back. And next turn, I think he doesn't get the KO with Spectre. I think he will target Feeny anyway, so what I want to do is go for Protect. I mean, at some point I have to target the Whimsy card, right? But I want to weaken Spectre as much as possible. Cause Whimsy card is not a threat, the only thing is it's annoying with Tailwind and stuff like that. But it's not a threat at all. That doesn't affect me, my friend. I should take this? Yeah, that's really good. I stalled out the max really, really effectively right now. And next turn... What do I do next turn? I think... I will like scary face the Spectre to force him to Tailwind to turn after that and call Mind. Because he's at minus 2, I have Light Skin, I will get to plus 1. Spectre just won't do any damage to my Feeny at this point. I know that next turn he can go for Tailwind and negate my scary face, but the idea is that he then has to... oh no, I'm at minus 1, right. I didn't think about that. I should take this? No, I don't. The crit mattered, definitely, because when he was at minus 1 he did like 9, not even 90, he did like 80 something. And now he was at minus 2. That's not good. I mean, it's not terrible, but that's not good. The good thing is that he's forced to Tailwind, and Spectre won't get a single KO here. I assume Rotom is in the back. So what I would like to do is... with Thunderbolt pick up the KO. Not too sure. I mean, I could... I think maxing him is the better play, right? Go for something... like max Flare into this slot. Smart Strike the... the Whimsicott. I max because I'm not sure that Thunderbolt will pick up the KO here. That's why I'm maxing. And I'm not maxing Katana because I assume he has Rotom in the back. And if I'm not maxing Rotom and he attacks Rotom with his 2 months, I may take too much damage. That's why I'm maxing Rotom here. By the way, Tailwind, he's forced to do that, but that means he won't get too much damage off this turn. Well, okay, so maxing Rotom maybe wasn't as needed. I'm really not sure whether or not I would have picked up the KO. I wanted to make it 100% safe. I think I should be fine. And the only bad part is, next turn he can get a fake TSM into my Rotom and safely target the Katana if he has Rotom in the back. And then it's Rotom versus Rotom. I have 1 turn of Dynamax, but I'm minus 2 special defense. And he has Tailwind, so he might win this. Oh, it's a fish. I mean, then I'm really glad that I set up the sun. Yeah, 100%. I can ignore Whimsicott. Yeah, I will ignore Whimsicott. Whimsicott isn't a threat at all anymore. Then Dynamax and Katana may have been the better play. Although I'm fine with that regardless. I should take this. Yeah, it's Sun. I resisted. I have pretty good defense and this should be game. Didn't think about Dracovish, I think. I thought that Rotom was by far the best option because he really didn't bring much for Katana. I mean, the two fairies don't do anything. And Dracovish isn't as good. Spectre is fine. I could have assumed that he doesn't have Rotom in the back based on him not switching it in turn 1. But still. Okay, Crimson Isle showed why it's so good. It effectively stalled out the Dynamax by its own. I mean, light screen and stuff like that is just super valuable. Okay, but you can see Spectre is really scary. If I don't stall out the max, it's nearly unwinnable. Because the thing with Spectre is just it's hard to play around because if it gets KOs, it pretty much ignores your special attack drop or your light screen, and that's just pretty hard to play around. Cool team, really cool team. And did we face 3 Whimsicott in a row? I didn't face Whimsicott at all before, and now I face 3 in a row. It's kind of funny. What I know is that Red Rock looks really good here. I don't know whether or not it's Dark Rush for water. I assume it's Dark, because otherwise you don't have a good Psychic switch in, and you have 2 weaknesses. So I think Dark is more likely, right? Zapdos is also a little bit scary. But I think Retrog is fine anyways with Crimson Isle. Then bringing Feeny as a fighting switch in, I assume. And for the last slot, it's between Landorus and Katana. Katana is a bit better versus the Porygon and stuff like that. Landorus is way better versus the Marowak. But am I as scared of Marowak? I don't think I have to. But the thing is, Landorus has Protect, Stall of Potential Trick Room and Tailwind Chance. So I think I will go with Landorus. Because Katana is really dead if Trick Room is up. I can't even stall it out with Katana. Yeah, that's fine. Maybe he leads with Trick Room stuff, then I get up some very free curses. Zapdos, Whimsicott, okay. Like, how much damage can Zapdos actually do to my Regirock? I don't know the Kalk. Isn't it better to switch out into Finny anyways? Just so tempting to go for Curse. But I don't know how much damage he will do. I mean, if it's Thunder, whatever it's called, it won't deal any damage, right? I think it's just so much better to switch out into Finny. I don't have to risk it. As tempting as it is to just curse up, I don't think it's worth. Dynamax. Has Zapdos any move that can really hit Finny? I don't think it had electric coverage, right? Doesn't it only have fighting, flying, and like stomping? I mean, Quake? Oh. That's funny, man. That's funny. Very good now that I didn't go for the curse play. That's smart because next turn you can just Dazzling Gleam. That was a really smart play. It's not Life Orb. I'm a little bit scared of potential policy. Could be policy. Although you don't have anything to trigger it. So I assume maybe. I really hate this format for that reason, because you never know whether or not your opponent has policy or not. Like, would you run policy Zapdos? I don't think so. I will set up Light Screen because I most likely won't get attack off anyway. And scary facing Zapdos would be the worst. Moonblast into... yeah, that was... well, that was to expect. Good thing is that we always sold out 2 turns of Dynamax. Oh, the only bad thing is if he like goes for multiple Max Knuckles now. This could go really bad really quick. Like, I don't know how much Max Knuckle will do to me, right? You could also think that I switch Regirock out. I think I would go for at least one curse. And maybe switch Grimmsnarl out? No, Max Airstream is a little bit too scary. I think I will just try to Spirit Break the Whimsicott. Yeah. Oh, he dives up into Ratchet Rock. No, he doesn't, okay. That's good for me, because next turn I can Dynamax. And then I can start getting KOs right and left. I will target the Zapdos, because Zapdos is kinda annoying for Landorus. As long as Zapdos is on the field, I cannot read switch in Landorus. Like, I could also target Whimsicott with... How many turns of Tailwind is that? Didn't he set up a Tailwind? He didn't, oh. Because Zapdos could protect. But honestly, I don't really care if it does. I want to get rid of Zapdos, and I don't... The thing is, I still think it could be policy, and I don't want to trigger policy. I really don't want to trigger a policy. So that's why I'm not going for... I mean, if he protects, I will trigger the policy, right? So maybe that wasn't the best play. The thing is, if he lives Moonblast, I could be in a bad spot. We will see. Yeah, I should not have targeted that. I'm really scared of policy. I should have thought more about that. Please don't be policy. Of course it is. Oh, that's bad. That's really not good. Because now it's a guessing game on who he targets. And I don't think I can afford to max guard with Ratchet, because if he targets Feeny, Landorus comes in, he gets the boost. I have to attack. I think I have to attack. Yeah, I really have to attack. I just should have maxed Rockfort, and now that I think about it a little bit more. Let's see, he's at +4, I'm +1 at reflex. Basically he does double. I don't think he can KO Regirock anyway. So maybe protecting Feeny would have been the play in case he targets it. But at the same time, I think he has to target the Regirock, right? Okay, he thinks he doesn't. You have to. But I had to target the Zapdos, because when I switch on Lando and Zapdos is still on the field, I'm screwed. The good thing is, he has pretty hard time to deal with Ratchet Rock now. Regardless of what he has in the back. I mean, Choice Band Water Urshifu could be annoying. But I don't think he have Water Urshifu. I think you have to run, like, Dark Urshifu on this team. We'll see. Urshifu, please be dark. That doesn't make any sense. I mean, water really doesn't make any sense on the team at all. Because you share all weaknesses with Zapdos. You share the psychic weakness, you share the electric weakness. That doesn't make any sense. I mean, electric seems to be fine because of the the Merowak, but now he has three psychic weaknesses. Like, how do you beat Ndidi Mail or Tapu Lele stuff? How do you beat it? You don't. You just lose. I don't get that at all. I really hate when people play with such bad teams. Man, I really hate that. Because there's not much I can do about it. Dark Urshifu, I think I would have a really good chance to win this, but with water... I won't deal enough damage with Retrobug, that's the thing. Yeah, he smartly targets around my Dynamax. That sucks so much, losing to people that have stupid things like that. That doesn't make any sense at all. It's just really stupid. That's not good at all, this team. I mean, he won, but that was based on me misplaying a bit. I mean, targeting Zapdos was definitely a misplay. I should have targeted Whimsicott, or at least target Zapdos with Max Rockfall. That was a big part. I was not allowed to allow him to trigger his policy. But now I think I'm screwed because he will deal too much damage with his Urshifu. I will try, but I don't think I will take Searching Strikes. If it's banned, I will not take it. If it's not banned, I might take it, but I assume it's... I mean, it could be Focus Sash, since Whimsicott had the eject button. This won't deal any damage, because of Light Screen and Sand. Let's see, 130 down to... That deals too much damage. This dealt 44, so maybe we can take it. Dealt a little bit less. Take it. Now it depends on what he has as the last one. I mean, we have to take two attacks, right? So I think we are screwed anyway, because Whimsicott did like 20. So the last one has to deal like 36 maximum to KO us. I mean, we are plus 1 defense, we have screens up, we have sand up. Merowak. I think Merowak will KO us. I don't think we can win this, but I try. Maybe we take it. Maybe there's a world where we take the attacks. I don't think so, but we will try. Protect, that's a start. Blast. Please hit. Okay. But I think my work deals a little bit too much damage, even with plus one. Our great defense ends the screen. Our Reflect was up, that was a smart play by him. I think with Reflect we could have taken the attack. Just barely. But without there's really no chance. GG's. I will do the calc actually, right now, on my smartphone, because I'm curious to know. Like, let's see, Pycalytics, Damage Calc, Regirock Rock, Default Set, with plus 1, and... Reflect versus Merowak. Alolan, Max Attack. Shadowbone wouldn't have dealt 82 to 34. So there was a decent chance that we take it with Reflect. But without reflect, it deals 42 minimum. So without reflect, there was no chance. So maybe there was a chance if I predicted the protect and like just drain punch the Whimsicott, which might have KO'd at plus 3. But I mean, Whimsicott was at like 50%. It might have been HP invested because it had eject button, resist fighting. I don't think it would have picked up the KO. But maybe there was a chance. There was definitely a chance with when I if I played like the turn versus Zapdos a bit better. Like Max Hazen was not to play at all. I should have Max Rockfort 100% of the time. Because it would have picked up the KO anyways and it wouldn't trigger the policy. Yeah. Okay, as always, thanks for watching. The team is, as always, PokePace and Vendor Code is in the description. Tomorrow will be a short breakdown on the team. Some thoughts about it. How I built the team and stuff like that. And on Monday, we will start with a fresh Buzzwole team. If you like the content, please like, share and subscribe. And yeah, enjoy your day. Thanks.